Hi everyone, my name is Ebi and I'm the Education and Outreach Assistant for Green Mountain Conservation Group. And today I am going to be showing you how to make a plastic bag pom-pom. This is a really great method of reusing your plastic bags because these are pretty difficult to recycle. The best plastic to recycle is plastic number 1, 2, and 5, and these are typically plastic number 4. So, you first of all want to try to not use these at all, but lots of us have a surplus of these in our houses, so finding a way to turn them into a decoration, a toy, an ornament is definitely preferable to throwing it away and putting it into the environment. So, for my materials today, I have a number of plastic bags. I have some more of these yellow ones here. I have some string or yarn. You can also use like a twisty tie or a rubber band, something that can you can use to bunch around a bundle of plastic. And I have some scissors. And then I have a piece of cardboard. You could also use your hand. I'm just going to use this to wrap my plastic strips around once I've made them so that it's nice and even. So the very first step that you're going to do is you're going to cut off the bottom of your bag right here, and you're going to cut off the handles at the top here to make it a square. Alright, so now we have this square of plastic, and we have these two hollow holes on either side. So you want those to be on the sides. And the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to fold it a number of times. You can roll it, you can fold it. You just want it to be a bit thinner so that it's easier to cut. And we are going to be cutting it into strips. And because the holes are on both sides, we'll end up having a thin loop of plastic, which we can use to make plarn, which if you haven't heard of plarn, plarn is plastic yarn. So there's a method to loop the loops together and pull them tight so that they connect, so that you can make a continuous string of plastic that you can use for a lot of activities, such as this. So I've rolled it. I'm going to just trim the ends so that it's nice and neat when I make my plastic loops. And now I'm going to make strips that are about an inch or so thick, maybe an inch and a half. And I'm gonna try to cut these nice and even so that I'll have even plarn. Alrighty. So now I have my plastic loops, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to connect the loops together to form my plarn. So the way you do this, now this is the part that can be a little bit tricky, is you're going to stick the end of one loop into another loop and then pull it back through itself, like that. And I'm going to have to keep doing this, so I'll show you one more time. I have this end of the plastic loop. I'm going to put it through and then pull it back through itself so that it connects like that. And you keep doing that. Okay, so I have made about 2 bags worth of plarn. So I have a lot of plarn to work with. So now I'm going to start wrapping my plarn. So like I said, you can either do this just sort of around your hands like this, but I also have this cardboard piece here, so that'll be even. And I'm just going to wrap it for a while. You want these to be pretty thick so that they'll puff out really nicely. Okay, So I have my yarn wrapped around my cardboard. I'm going to set that down and grab my string. Now, whatever you're using to tie with is just fine. I'm going to cut this a little bit longer so that I can make it into an ornament so I can hang it from our tree. So I'm going to just carefully slide my bunch of yarn off of my cardboard. And about where I think the middle is, I'm gonna make it nice and tight in the middle. I'm going to tie my string so that it's even on both sides. And you wanna tie this nice and tight because then that means it's more likely that you'll have a poofier pom-pom. So I'm going to just tie a nice tight knot in the middle there. And then I'm also going to tie the top together so that I have an ornament so that I can hang it. And now comes the fun part. I get to see how my pom-pom turned out. So you have a bunch of loops here and here. You now are going to have to cut through all these loops. And the plastic can be a little thick sometimes, so this can be a little tricky. This may need some adult assistance. But once you do this, you'll find that your plarn will puff out nicely into a beautiful pom-pom. And you can also try this with different colors of bags. In the instructions that I have on our website, you can see that the example there has some pink and some yellow and some blue, and it looks really good. So if you have multiple colors, you definitely should go for that. You can see that it's already starting to poof out as I'm cutting up these loops. You gotta kind of get in there and try to find any little loops that are hiding in the middle. Make sure those are cut so that they'll poof. And this kind of a craft, as I said, is really important because this stuff is really hard to recycle. And we also use a lot of plastic bags. It is one of the most commonly used types of plastic in the United States and in the world. They'll end up in the oceans. They can look like jellyfish and be eaten by sea turtles who really love to eat jellyfish. And you know, this is something that is on average used for about 12 to 15 minutes, yet stays in the environment for hundreds of years. It takes a very long time for this to break down. So long that you could basically say it doesn't really break down, at least not in any of our lifetimes. So all the pieces of plastic that have ever been made are still on the planet today, which is very scary because we don't have that much room. Okay, now that it is poofing out, you can take a look at it. Mine is kind of wonky on this side, so I'm gonna trim it a little bit there. And that is how you make your plastic bag pom-poms.